You could be the muse to my passion. We can make love like an act of God. I just match my words to my actions. Magic in my life's everlasting. I say, I could add a world up, be with any girl. Something about your sound makes me wanna man up. We should fill our cups, catch a flick and do some stuff. I'm just the one that stands, but with you that's not enough. I don't wanna front, I just wanna see ya. Please give me a sign, yeah. Please give me a sign if you wanna come. Please give me a sign, yeah. I don't wanna front, I just wanna see ya. Please give me a sign if you wanna come. Sending games, I don't wanna play. I've been on my grind, I just wanna lay down with you. Spark a doobie, hit the town with you. Life is complicated, but I. Well, hello, and welcome back with me, Adam H, with another video. Today we're on Euro Truck Simulator 2. We're starting off in Birmingham. And we are going to be going to Swansea. We've just got to go and pick our load up. We're going to be transporting a load of logs to say to Swansea. And so hopefully everything will be alright today and we'll get the load successfully delivered. And delivered on time. So we're trying to get videos out every Tuesday and Thursday at least. Just trying to keep on top of it. Which you know, one of the days, this week was January. Didn't quite go to plan where I missed a Tuesday. But that was because of work. Obviously, started my new job first week of Jan, so obviously, wasn't able to get it all sorted out. So I need to obviously focus on that before getting the videos uploaded. But we're back now. Now the videos are scheduled now, so they actually are being uploaded. Switch my mouse back to the gaming one, so we've got a choice of two. It doesn't really matter which one, we'll just keep it with that one. No fancy, so we'll take the job. We'll see where that trailer is in this yard. This around here. It's a very messy yard of logs. It is there. So what we're gonna do? It's not that one. I'll have to jackknife it if it were that one to get it out. Which jackknifing is for? I've actually done it in real life. Controlled, obviously. Controlled jackknife. Where I work, I know that you wouldn't normally pick the trail up like this, but we are. But some of the jobs that I deliver to in real life,
we have to actually jackknife the trailer to turn around. Mom, open the gates, please. They open towards me, I know that, and don't want them to hit the truck. There we go. So you always got to be cautious when you're jackknifing trailers, though. It's one thing you've got to remember is when you do jackknife the trailer goes backwards and all. Now after a certain point, it starts shoving the trailer back. You've got to be aware of what's behind you and all. Quite nervy, but you can do it. Some of the jobs that I've done. Thanks for the driving training. Was recording driving then, and and some of them are like, we shouldn't be going in here with an Arctic, really. I don't think that it's possible, but yeah, we do. Like a couple of centimetres off of hitting a brick wall when you turn it, so it's tight, very tight. Got to have your wits about you. Come on, get power up. Let this car past and we can get out. Officially say I've driven every truck brand now, every truck manufacturer here in the UK, anyway. And the best one is Scania, by far. Lovely trucks to drive, Scanias. Always have liked Scanias. What is this car doing? Is it just going to sit and dawdle? Yes, it is. I hate when cars do that. Sit on the near side, not going fast enough, max your speed, you sit there, you're stuck in middle lane and you can't even get over. But when that happens, you just got to put your indicator on and force your way over sometimes if they don't get the message, which isn't a nice thing to do, never is. Sometimes they give you no choice. And you just get them cutting you up and everything, it's crazy. Or slowing you down on a hill and you're fully loaded. That's a nightmare and all. About 44 ton on you and the car's slowing you down on a hill. It's an absolute nightmare it is. Especially when you're coming past Manchester, if you know the M62 at all. There's a few wood hills on there. Especially the stuff that I deliver is quite heavy. So it's going up them hills, full loaded back to right to the back doors. You've got to try and keep your speed up. And then hit the hill at a reasonable speed and keep your foot down. Pardon me. It doesn't always work like that. Always someone who slows you down, so then you slow right down to about 40. I think the other day I was going up there about 40, 35 miles per hour because someone slowed me down and I lost all momentum. And I couldn't struggling to regain momentum, so first. That's how important it is not to slow trucks down, especially on hills. It's a struggle to get back going again, especially if they're fully loaded. If they're empty, they're not too bad. They can get back, they slow down a tiny bit, but not much. Okay, we're not going into Swansea this way, so we must be going in the other way to Swansea. So we'll get our indicator on and move over. Coming off the next junction for Swansea, hopefully. Fingers crossed. Power up the sail. Let's see if the sat nav knows where it's going. That's happened before. The sat nav doesn't know where you're going. But they're addressing it. It's never heard of it before. That's happened a few times. This driver's running at speed, so we'll get over. That annoys me at all when they're going slow, then all of a sudden notice the truck trying to overtake them, the speed up and put the foot down. That's really annoying. Hey, they've slowed you down. So you have to slow down obviously to make sure it's clear to get into the other lane. Then they put the foot down like this person's just done here. Prime example. And then pull in front of you like that. Yeah. That wasn't planned at all. I'm actually enjoying driving the Arctics now. There's a few jobs that I have to do with. They're quite tight and they're not a nice drop, let's put it that way. You have to do a load of messing around, shunting, and some of them it's like, geez, why have we got this star on an Arctic? Be easy and rigid, but you can do it if you've got to take your time. That's one thing about being driving trucks is some days can be very long hours. Very long. You talk about average hours. I normally do between 10 and 13 hours a day. 5 days a week. So we do an awful lot of hours. It's very tiring at times. Constantly working. Everyone whinges. Oh, truck drivers moaning about stuff, but you know what it is. Wages are okay. Where's the bills? Allows me to save up. Save money up for this new studio that I'm building. And upgrading the system and all. for as long as it is for my hobbies. So all that matters, that's what we go off to work for, to pay the bills and pay for our hobbies. We just go in and get on with it. Up with the shit at sometimes, but you know, it's what it is. Have your good days, you have your bad days. Which is easier said than done. Some days you can have some right bad days. It's like you're off my way, delivering to supermarkets and Aldi's. Yeah. You're going in and you're crossing your fingers that there's no truck on the bay. Because if there's a truck on the bay, you've got to sit and wait for the truck to finish unloading. I've been quite lucky. I've gone in and there has been a truck on the bay, but I've only had to wait like 5 to 15 minutes recently. So not had to wait long to get on the bay to tip and then to get back. You know, imagine if you had that at every store. Jeez. It'd be absolutely horrendous. Really would, but you know, it's all part of the job, sadly. It's like my run, I do 2 days in Wales and 3 days in Manchester, and I can get back to the yard quicker when I'm on the Wales run. I can get in about 2 o'clock back into the yard, 2:30, 1:30. Back in the yard on a Mount Wales, on the Wales run, and we run out from Leeds, so you know, Wales can be a quick day for me. But then when I'm in Manchester, you know, I'll be getting back in the yard about 3:30. That's closer to home, but we've got more drops on. It's crazy. We just get delayed half the time on some of the drops. It's absolutely horrendous. So we have good drops and we have bad drops. Some of them are absolutely awful. But thankfully, we don't always have them on. Some we get to change around a bit. So that, I think the runs that I had on last week, I don't normally have on my run, but some added extras. So for this week I won't have them on, fingers crossed. That's what I'm hoping anyway, because it's absolutely chaos if they are on again. 10 drops a day. Some of them you can fire them off in 10 minutes and get out of there. And some takes forever. Some drops can take 30 minutes. Yeah, it just depends on how many cages they've got. It's absolutely crazy. Then goes on the store. Some of them have the loading bays, like on a slope like that, no matter how much you lower the truck back to unit suspension right down, bring the nose of the trailer down and lift the back end of the trailer up, it's still sloping. It's dangerous, very dangerous, especially when you've got stuff on wheels. I don't want to stay still and they just want to roll down the trailer all at once. That's a nightmare. Had that one drop in Manchester. First time going to it. didn't know what to expect. Did what I trained, lower air out of the tractor unit, put the trailer up. The whole load moved. And I was fighting with it to get it back and secure so I could go to the next job, and it was messy, let's put it that way. It really took it out of me. I was absolutely knackered by the end of that day. Absolutely awful day, that one. And I lost time and everything. It put an extra hour on my day. So an hour, I could have done 12 hours, 12 or 11 hours that day, but I had to do 13. 13 and a half actually. All because of that one drop that caused havoc the rest of the day. So it's crazy. Obviously it's one of these things you can't rush. You've got to take your time. Securing it and everything, but if you're not happy with it, press the wrong button then. Sorry traffic if I slowed you down. Press the wrong button again. Cause absolutely carnage. Swansea discovered death. So it is our first time coming into Swansea. I'll drop the speed down because it is going down to 30 and there's a copper there. We don't want to get a speeding ticket and we have to cross the main carriageway here. We'll take this gap. It's coming into Unilever. Bit strange that Unilever want the logs. Slow it down again. Getting a bit carried away with the accelerator. And the good thing nowadays we try and do is just try and coast it. So it saves a bit of fuel. Not putting power on the engine, you're not making the engine work, just letting it coast. Here we are, Unilever, the final destination. Can they open the gates for us? Yeah, of course they are. Down the gear because I don't think we'll get going in time. Go, stop that. Alright, where do they want it? They want it right there. The best thing is, try and get your positioning from the start. It's in. Is a bit of an awkward one because there's not a lot of space. Might have to take a shunt here. Yeah, I'm gonna take a shunt here. Try again. If you're always unsure, take a shunt, get out and have a look. Okay. Lower the legs. disconnect everything, and there we go.
Job's a good one.
So, that is it for this video.
Don't forget to like and subscribe to the channel for further content on Euro Truck Simulator 2 and Farming Simulator 22. And I'll see you in the next video. Thanks for watching.
I just wanna see you. Please give me a sign if you wanna come through.